In recent years, more and more manufacturers have launched many different ultra-thin game chargers, including Realme, Tagic, and Basis. ChargerLab also recently got an ultra-thin 65 watts GaN charger from Ohi. Today, we'll take it apart to see its internal structure and how it is made so thin. First, let's remove the sealing plastic. The packaging box is black with patterns of different electronic products. Flip to the back, multiple sealing points and specs info are printed on the back. Take out the charger. Some documents are hidden under the black foam. Here is the charger, looks like a biscuit. It adopts a black translucent design and feels really geeky. The Ohi and 65 are printed on the front. The yellow triangle logo points to the USB-C port. Let's take a look at all specs info. Model is AOC-C013. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 1.6A. The maximum output in PD mode can reach 65W, but under the PPS protocol, the highest power only reaches 33W. A major feature of this charger is that the input casing can be opened and closed. When closed, it can hide the prongs inside the casing, which can protect the device from scratches. There are two magnets and a groove between the two prongs that allow the user to easily unfold the casing. After unfolding, the charger can be plugged into the wall outlet more stably. The prongs can be rotated, which can save space in the socket and make it more flexible to use. The output end has a yellow USB-C port. There is an indicator light next to the USB-C. The indicator light has three states. It lights up yellow when fast charging, blue when standard charging, and green when trickle charging. And the size of this charger is about 14.22 by 104 by 60 mm, but when the case is unfolded, its length is reduced to about 88 mm. It is so thin and compact, weighing about 98 grams. It is smaller than Apple's 65W charger, and the thickness is only about one-third of Apple's 65W charger. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it can support UFCS, FCP, SCP, AFC, QC3.05, PD3.0, PPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4A charging protocols. It has 5 fixed videos of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. After testing, let's use the spudger to pry along the gap. Two parts of the charger are fixed by ultrasonic welding, and a graphite thermal pad is attached to one side of the cover. The PCBA module is filled with potting compound to enhance heat dissipation. The rotatable prongs are fixed with screws. And they are connected to the input end of the PCB through wires. The fuse, common mode choke, electrolytic capacitor for input filtering, and planar transformer around the front of the PCBA module. Flip to the back, we can also see the capacitors and planar transformer, a clever design. There are some MOSFETs and chips surrounding the transformer. ChargerLab found it adopts QR flyback topology. The mass control chip is from Solergy. The rectifier controller outputs a wide range voltage, which is adjusted by the protocol chip through the optocoupler. The input fuse marked with 936 is from Betterfuse, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. This is the first SMD common mode choke, and the other one is wound with magnet wires. The X2 safety capacitor is from WQC, 0.33 microfarad. Two Panjet bridge rectifiers are connected in a half bridge, which can dissipate heat evenly, 4 amp, 1000 volts. The two electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Barrel. There are 400 volts 33 microfarad and 400 volts 22 microfarad respectively. The third barrel electrolyte capacitor for input filtering is also 400 volts, 22 microfarad. The differential mode choke has an I-shaped magnetic core inside. The fourth electrolyte capacitor is 400 volts, 27 microfarad, so the total capacity is 104 microfarad. The mass control chip, or we can say GaN-IC, is from Silogy, marked with FMR-FFA. This electrolyte capacitor can power the mass control chip we just mentioned, 10 microfarad, 100 volts. The planar transformer is insulated by a plastic frame and is produced by TechHigh. These are two SMDY capacitors, and the other two SMDY capacitors are from ISND. They were connected in series. The Everlight optocoupler is used to regulate upper voltage through feedback. The synchronous rectifier controller is also from Silogy. It supports QR flyback and ZVS flyback topology, and it has adaptive gate voltage control and adopts DFN 2x3-8 package. The synchronous rectifier is from AOS and adopts DFN 5x6 package, 100 volts, 2.9 milliohm. Two solid capacitors for output filtering are from Barrel CH series, 220 microfarad, 25 volts for each. The protocol chip is from Indronic and is used for USB ports. It supports multiple fast charging protocols. The VBUS MOSFET is from Vergiga Semi and adopts PDFN 3333 package, 30 volts, 5.2 milliohm. This SMD LED indicator is used to indicate charging status. The USB-C connector is from CZT. Well, that will be all the components of this translucent charger. The rotatable and foldable prongs make it more flexible to use. After taking it apart, we found the planar transformer and other components are placed in the hollow of the PCB to reduce the thickness. Even though it is so thin and light, it can still support up to 65 watts PD, but it only reaches 33 watts under PBS mode. So if you want to put the charger into your pocket and enjoying fast charging, you may consider this charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.